Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Right now, Granite Staters are cleaning up after another blast of winter weather. Here's a look in Manchester for you right now. Flakes are still falling right now at 12:30. Some places are now dealing with more than a half foot of snow. Driving conditions are back on track pretty much after a messy morning commute as you take a live look out at Hooksett. Ray Brewer reports from Francistown.
Overnight and throughout the morning, the snow was continuing to fall across much of New Hampshire. And while most people were still asleep, the cleanup was underway, getting roads ready for the morning commute. Francistown was one of the areas to see the most snow, as about 7 to 8 inches fell, but it was not your typical January storm.
It's springtime consistency and should be nice and fluffy in January. That's what we'd like to see.
Instead, it was a heavy, wet snow that brought down some power lines in parts of the state and created its own set of problems for the road crews.
One of the things we're running into is it pushes hard, but it doesn't take much to get the truck stuck. You don't even have to really be in any predicament, but you just turn a tire and it spins and there you sit.
Just up the road, Ron Rupp was doing his own cleanup, not having too much of a problem with what the storm left behind.
A little bit heavier, but not bad. The snow blower is doing a good job and took me about a half hour.
In neighboring Bennington, town crews were out clearing the sidewalks in the downtown area and pushing the snow out of the way. Also pushing the snow was Joshua Siegel, who was cleaning off his four cars. However, he was also taking his time.
I'm an old guy, so I'm very careful about how much I push myself when I'm shoveling snow.
Siegel was also getting ready to leave all this behind, joining his wife in Florida. And while some might be jealous, he says he'd rather stay and ski. And at Crotchet Mountain, there were people doing just that as they celebrated the snowfall, saying this is just what they needed.
It means a good 8 inches pressed out into a firm base over the snowmaking we did last weekend in the real cold temps to recover from all that rain. So we're in great shape.
And right now, crews are on the scene in Manchester after a snowplow struck a utility pole this morning. That accident happened on Lakeshore Road near Candia Road, leaving down power lines. Part of the road was closed as crews worked to replace the pole. Luckily, no injuries were reported. From the snow, we're headed right back to mild temperatures, and that's leading to the postponement of the 7th annual Black Ice Pond Hockey Championships at White Park. It was scheduled for the weekend of January 27th. Organizers say that the new date for the popular tournament is now the weekend of February 10th. The games will start that Friday at 9 a.m. On our website right now, you can check out snow totals town by town, and we want to see what the snow looks like where you live. Don't forget to upload your pictures at ulocal.wmur.com. Manchester police are investigating an overnight shooting on Spruce Street. In this exclusive surveillance video only obtained by News 9, you can see two suspects leaving the scene where police say a homeowner was shot. Police say the shooting happened on Spruce Street at 12:30 this morning. They say the shooting was targeted and premeditated. Police say a man living in the area was shot in his hand inside his home, but he'll be okay. Surveillance video shows the suspects leaving. You can clearly see one of them has a foot injury. Police say the homeowner is not cooperating.
It's frustrating for our detectives who work tirelessly when they go to an incident like this. When you have uncooperative victims, it makes it all the more difficult to come up with a positive solution or conclusion to a case when the victims are highly uncooperative, such as this incident.
Here's that surveillance video one more time of the two suspects leaving a residence on Spruce Street early this morning. If you have any information about the suspects, please contact Manchester Police. Right now, Manchester police are also actively investigating a shooting on the west side. Officers responded to Dubuque Street around 8:30 this morning for a gunshot call. Police say one victim was involved, but at this point they're not releasing any further details while the investigation continues. Starting tonight at 5 o'clock, if a self-driving car sees a collision coming, should it swerve to protect its passengers or the people on the street? That is just one of the ethical questions being considered in this new technology. We're going to take a look. And while we're watching the inauguration this Friday, White House staff will be rushing to get ready for the new first family. We're going to take you behind the scenes at the White House. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.